CNN. A detailed ISIS operative has been providing crucial information on the militant group's chemical weapons program. The U.S. military is now acting on that information, launching airstrikes mainly around the city of Mosul in Iraq. Let's get some more on all of this. Joining us, Republican Senator Ron Johnson of Wisconsin. He's joining us from Capitol Hill. He's the chairman of the Senate Homeland Security Committee, the Governmental Affairs Committee. Senator, let's talk about this operation to take out ISIS chemical weapons. What can you tell us about this? Because obviously it's very disturbing.
Well, CNN has done a good job reporting on it. And, you know, this is good news. We're taking out chemical weapons, but it also indicates two things. First of all, we have to defeat ISIS, because when they're not defeated, they're left to actually produce chemical weapons and use them, you know, in violation of war standards, as well as it also shows how important it is to actually capture terrorists. I'm all for killing terrorists, but it's better if we can capture them and then question them, because we get information that's required, human intelligence, to defeat them. So unfortunately, President Obama wanted to close Guantanamo Bay. We haven't been capturing, we haven't been detaining, we haven't been questioning to gather that kind of intelligence. So it indicates an awful lot of things. It's good news, we're getting this intelligence, that we're able to destroy some of these chemical weapons, but it certainly indicates the dangers we really face by not defeating ISIS.
He hasn't let up, though, on these airstrikes, manned airstrikes and drone unmanned airstrikes. Yesterday, we learned that a top ISIS leader known as Omar the Chechen is believed to have died in a U.S. airstrike. The day before, about 150 al-Shabaab terrorists were believed to have been killed in a U.S. manned and unmanned airstrikes. It looks like it's full speed ahead in this air war against ISIS. I assume you're on board with the president on this.
Absolutely. And, you know, I support those airstrikes. We should be killing these terrorists wherever they reside. And, of course, the Special Operations Forces are doing the capturing and killing. And, you know, God bless them for doing that. But bottom line is, we actually have to accomplish the goal that President Obama laid out 17 or 18 months ago, which is actually defeat ISIS. Because as long as they're not overtly losing, they're going to continue to be perceived as winning. They'll inspire. They'll continue to spread. They'll deepen their roots. They'll produce additional chemical weapons, use additional chemical weapons. We have to defeat them, and so we've got to be more committed to that accomplishing of that actual goal.
Senator, for the second day in a row, Iran has now test-fired two ballistic missiles. Some are saying this is a violation of the Iran nuclear agreement. I know you voted against that nuclear deal, but is it a violation?
Well, it's certainly a violation of other UN resolutions to prevent them from doing this. You know, President Obama was hoping that the Iranian nuclear agreement would modify Iran's behavior. I mean, he was right, it modified it, but it modified it to the worse. The Ayatollahs have become emboldened by our weakness. They're poking a stick in our eye. They're threatening, obviously, Israel. They're threatening the region. They've become more dangerous because they've actually now received about $100 billion of funds into their economy, into their military. I think that was a very unwise agreement. I think it's proving to be exactly that.
Has that $100 billion already been provided to the Iranians as part of the nuclear agreement, or is that money that is, let's say, in the pipeline?
That's what they were claiming. You know, the administration was not exactly forthright in exactly how many funds would flow into Iran how soon, but we knew it was going to be tens, hundreds, a hundred plus, hundreds of billions eventually. Iran was saying that they've already, and they're crowing about it, that they'd already basically recovered or had access to about $100 billion. I think that's very foolish. Why would you want to inject that amount of capital into the economy and military of a self-proclaimed enemy, the acknowledged largest state-sponsored terror in the world? I think it's very foolish.
Senator, thanks very much for joining us. Obviously, a lot of critical issues. We didn't even have a chance to get to North Korea, what's going on, but we will on a later occasion. Appreciate it very much, Senator Ron Johnson of Wisconsin.
Have a good day.